Hello, in this video I want to show you how to plot survey plan in Revit. You know, the traditional way of plotting survey plan is through AutoCAD, but that will slow you down, especially if you are using Revit. So it is faster and easier for you to plot your survey plan in your Revit so that you continue your work in Revit. Right away, this is a survey plan we are going to be using, and we'll get to our Revit, and this is a faster way of doing it. This is quite better than using AutoCAD. So I am going to go to Massing and Site, then I will click on this little button here, and that will bring this dialog box up. Then here we are going to select degrees, and we are going to hit apply and click OK. Then we click on property line and hit create by entering distances and bearing. Then here we are going to go to our plan. Here we can decide to go either we go clockwise or anti-clockwise, whatever way you want to go. So I will be going anti-clockwise. So I want to start from this line first, and if you look at this line, what we have is 18.3 meters, and mind you, we are going to convert all these to millimeter because I am using millimeter in this whole project. And make sure the unit you are using should be the same thing. If you are using meter, then use meter, and if you are using millimeter, then use millimeter. But in this project I use millimeter, so I am going to be typing all this in the appropriate sections. First of all, I'm going to type the distance, which is 18,300, and the degree is 157 degrees, and the minute is 008. So I will type 1300, and the bearing is 157, and the minute is 08. I will hit insert. Then the next one is this very line. I will have 18,300. And the bearing is 24, so let's go. We'll type 18,300, and the bearing is 72, and the minute is 24. This is quite better than using AutoCAD. Then the next one is this very line, and we have 17,150, and the bearing is 336, and the minute is 10 minutes. All right, so we are going to type 17,150, and the bearing is 336, and the minute is 10, and I'll hit insert. Then the last and not the least is this very line, and we have 18,150, the bearing is 256, and the minute is 07. So we go here, we type 18,150, and the bearing is 256, and the minute is 07. So I will hit OK, and here is our survey plan in Revit, exactly as we have in our survey plan. Now let's confirm whether these distances are correct. Let's confirm whether they are correct. So I want to add dimension to all these to check whether they are correct. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to use line, and I'm going to type the offset to be like 500. And I will trim this place off. Okay, let me still trim this place off. Okay, then I'm going to use extend. The reason why I'm doing this is because it is at an angle. That is the way I dimension something like this, that is at an angle. So when you select this line, you click on this, you select it, you click on it, you select this, you click on it, and you select this, you click on it. Okay, now let's look at what we have. We have this side, we have 17 meters, and this is 18,147, and this is 18,309, and this is 18,200 and something. Okay, by mainly looking, you should be able to know that the road is on this end, and this is where we have this 17 meter, which is this. So we are going to rotate this to align with what we have in our survey. So I am going to rotate it. I will rotate it like this so that, okay, 17 is on the left and 18,150 is down. So I'm still going to rotate it further. I want to make sure that this is vertical because that's the way I want to be working with it. Okay, so if you look at our survey, 17 meter is on the left and 18.15 is down, and that is exactly what we have here. Don't mind these, it's just a minor roundup. So this is 18,150 and this is 17,150. So this one is up, which is correct. 18.3, this one, don't mind the minor roundup. So this one is correct. So that is what we have. So at this point I will save it, and thank you for watching this video. If you benefit anything from this video, give this video a thumbs up and don't forget to give me a review. Thank you. And see you in the next video. Bye.